I've never seen a diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies, and I'm not proud of my address. In a torn up town, no postcode envy, but every song's like gold teeth, grey goose dripping in the bathroom, bloodstains, ball gowns, trash in the hotel room. We're driving Cadillacs in our dreams, but everybody's like crystal Maybach diamonds on.
Well, pop-up dinners have gained some popularity over the past couple of years. For us with Café Momentum, you know, we're a post-release internship for kids coming out of jail. And when you start to tell people that you want to take kids out of jail and teach them to play with knives and fire, there are some pretty obvious questions. So a pop-up dinner was a great solution for us to be able to demonstrate our organization and how our restaurant concept would work.
Big fans of Café Momentum and kind of follow them since their implementation not too long ago. Love the concept, love the fact that it's helping out troubled youth and helping them get into something that we're big fans of, and that's the food industry. We love food and wine, and we thought it'd be the perfect complement to go with what we're trying to do here as well.
It was kind of a collaborative effort with a small group of us. How did we approach on a wing and a prayer to start? Our first pop-up, we wanted to have, we decided 50 guests at $50 each, and we didn't know what to expect. We didn't know if anybody would show up. There's certainly, you know, questions about the guys, legitimate questions. A lot of them have never done fine dining service or been in a fine dining restaurant. A lot of them are unsure of some of the ingredients that they're actually cooking with and serving. So there were a lot of questions. But the first dinner, we did 50 guests at $50 each, and we actually sold out in 24 hours. We actually oversold before we could put our PayPal down, and sold 68 seats. And since then, we've done 25 more over the course of a little over 2 years. We're now charging between $100 and $125 a ticket, and we're selling out in about 15, 20 seconds.
Yeah, here it's the hardest chair to book.
Yeah, so one of the things that we like to focus on here is not just about coming in, buying whatever wine is on the shelf. We really want our customers to understand what they're getting, to experience the wine. That's why we do things with Scardello. We're doing an event in the next couple of weeks with Cane Rosso around pizza and other esoteric Italian wines that you wouldn't normally buy to go with pizza. So things like that that we really want to kind of push the envelope, get thinking, people thinking about more than Cabernet on a grocery store shelf, and really try to connect those two dots for everybody. Very much so. Yeah, it's a lot of fun too. So, I mean, let's be frank, at the end of the day, we're drinking juice and having a good time.
Well, we do have an entire 240-pound Red Waddle pig that we have prepared six different ways. We've prepared porchetta with the belly and the loin. We've made chicharrones with the skin. We're smoking the ribs. We're doing some pulled pork. We made ham, head cheese. So it's gonna be very fun. And then everything else has come within 50 miles of the Wine Poste.